Hey, Trinity. Welcome to our service today. It's a little bit different, whether you're watching on Wednesday night or you're watching on Reset. I hope you enjoy this few moments that we have together to just let the church thank you and show our thankfulness to God for His mercy and grace in this time that we are about to enter in Thanksgiving and Advent. I'm very thankful for this congregation. I've been doing this for a very, very long time, and I have found a congregation here at Trinity that is just one of the most awesome group of people to ever work with, and I truly mean that from the bottom of my heart. Last Thanksgiving was a little different and hectic for me and my family as I was recovering through a heart attack and open heart surgery. And I am so thankful, first of all, to God's mercy and grace that I'm still with my family and I'm with you all today. And I am very thankful for so many things, but it comes down to people. It comes down to relationships with my God, with my family, and with you, the Trinity Congregation. So enjoy today and happy Thanksgiving to you and your family. And we'll see you soon.
Hi, I'm Bruce Peterson. This Thanksgiving, I'm very grateful and thankful that I had the honor to be on honor flight of the Quad City flight number 52. A wonderful experience. The national greatest asset is its military men and women. Happy Thanksgiving.
I am thankful for my family, both found and blood related, because they always find a way to cheer me up when I'm sad.
And I'm thankful for time.
I'm thankful for my friends.
I'm thankful for my family, my friends, and the opportunity to be part of Trinity staff.
It was Thanksgiving morning, and I was sick. And not the dainty, manageable kind of sick. I was sick. There was so much still to be done. Supplies to gather, food to prepare, and an 18-pound turkey to roast. So my dear husband decided to enlist help. If he were smart, he would have just called his mother or his sister-in-law, but no, he called his brother Paul. Now, let me just say, seeing the two of them in action is what made me understand why animals eat their young. Neither of them had any real experience in the kitchen. In fact, they had about as much business preparing a holiday dinner as I did playing linebacker in the NFL. The only meal I'd ever seen my husband prepare was a bowl of cereal. And Paul? Well, Paul had his own set of difficulties when it came to food prep. I'm not exactly sure what went on in the kitchen that day, but judging from the commotion, the laughter, and one actual scream, I was pretty sure it was something I wasn't going to be thankful for. Good intentions can go a long way, but you need more than intentions to roast a turkey. On Thanksgiving, most of us stop and reflect on the tangible things we're thankful for. Our health, our family. However, on that Thanksgiving, I didn't have my health and I couldn't be with my family. I felt alone and somewhat forgotten. Then I remembered a time in the Bible when Moses felt alone. He wanted to see God to try and make sense of his circumstances. In turn, God said he would make his goodness pass right in front of him. And God's goodness was more than enough. I guess the trick is, no matter what the circumstance you find yourself in on Thanksgiving, or any day, is to see God's goodness and to thank him for it. Oh, and by the way, that Thanksgiving may have ended up being the best one we've ever had. Thanks to the dinner being overcooked, undercooked, and in some parts raw, our family started the first annual Thanksgiving Leftovers food fight. Sure, it's silly and a whole lot of fun, but this tradition has become an annual reminder to our whole family that no matter how messy our lives get, we can still be thankful for God's goodness.
On this Thanksgiving, I am especially thankful for my friends and family, both near and far. Family in like four corners of the United States who I won't be able to spend the day with, but are always in my heart and close by. And so I'm additionally thankful for my friends, those of you here in this community who are so very much my family. So happy Thanksgiving to everyone, and thank you for your friendship.
Hello, everyone. It is Thanksgiving week here in the U.S. It's a time when we get together with family and friends and we eat. Perhaps we watch some football. We rest a little bit from our labors. Some go shopping like crazy. But whatever it is a time that we pause and do many of the things that we like to do. Thanksgiving, as much as people might think, is relatively easy to do, right? Especially those of us who are at a certain place in our lives and we look around at our home and our families, we look around at our church, we look around at everything that we have been given or that we have accumulated, and we realize pretty quickly that our cornucopia, as it were, is overflowing. So we look at it and we say, yes, absolutely, I'm thankful. We know that for lots of folks, this time of year isn't overflowing with food or goods or things, even places to stay. So Thanksgiving means a lot of different things to a lot of different people. But for all of us, it calls us to remember two things. The first is that no matter what station of our life that we are in, we are young or we are old or we are employed or unemployed, whether we are hopeful or not hopeful, whatever it might be, there's probably something this week that we can be thankful for. Maybe it's the people who raised us. Maybe it's the things that we were taught years ago, the values and the ways of caring. Maybe it's one little item or trinket that we have from our childhood. Whatever it might be, all of us can find something that we are genuinely thankful for. And then here's the second. The second thing is, what are we going to do about it? We can say we're thankful, but it can't stop there. Our own faith tradition reminds us that we are thankful to God for all that we are given. And then God asks us, what are you going to do next? How are you going to live a life in the world that demonstrates that you're thankful? Well, it's really up to each and every one of us, but I encourage you to really give that some thought this week. How will people know? If they know you well, or just see you on the street, or walking around a store, whatever it might be, do you give off the vibe, if you will, that you're thankful? Would people know that you know the value of all the gifts that you've received throughout your life? For some people, this week, it's not only eating food, but giving food to others. For a lot of people this week, it's not just shopping, but shopping for others. For some people, it's not just being thankful for their dwelling, but perhaps giving some money or time to an organization like Habitat for Humanity so others may have a place to live. Whatever it might be. But I want you to think about, too, this scene, this setting. What makes you thankful for your congregation? What makes you thankful for Trinity? And what are you going to do about it? So, Thanksgiving, absolutely a time to rest a little bit, to pause a little bit, to take stock in all that we have. But also a moment to rest and pause, to take stock in all that we can share, all that we can give to those around us. So, I hope you and your family have a wonderful Thanksgiving day and a wonderful Thanksgiving week. And I hope that you and your family and your friends will live a life of thankfulness. Not just one day or one week a year, but every day. Grateful for what we have, for who we are, and for whose we are. Amen.
How can I say thanks for all the things that you've done for me? Things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me. The voices of a million could not express my gratitude, all that I am and ever hope to be. I owe it all to thee. Thank you.
I'm thankful for everything that God has done for me and my family, both my biological family and my family through God.
What I'm thankful for are my friends, my family, and all the blessings God has given me in my life.
I'm thankful for my family and friends because they're very supporting. They're always there for me.
I'm thankful for my phone.
And I think over the longevity of time right now, of health is probably as much as anything, because we've all had our times of health problems. And in today's world, there's so much going on health-wise that if we can stay healthy, continue to be healthy, do what we need to be healthy, seems to me most everything for your own sake and everybody else just falls into place. We just take care of ourselves, take care of each other.
For my mama, for my friends, for your love that never ends, for the songs that make us dance on this old dirt floor. For my babies, for my girl, for the way they changed my world. You're waking up today, yeah, I just gotta say, thank you, Lord.
Times, for lighting the way in the dark times, for pulling me in, for giving again the times that I took it too far. I gotta thank you for keeping me humble, for picking me up when I stumble. And although I change, you stay the same. And I don't say thank you enough. For my mama.